So God is. When we think of that in terms of the five principles that you've been talking about, 1 through 4, God is. And 5, where I stand, where I move, where I work, where I play, where I dance. So the 5th principle, it's not enough to be knowers of truth, but we must live the truth we know. God is animating us in that truth. God is the great animator of everything we do. So while we each come with our own spiritual gifts, our own past life experiences, and past life experiences, we each come with our own wounds, with our own passion, with our own hopes, with our own dreams. There's one animator carrying us through that. And that is in, with, and by the power of love that we move. So when we say we're taking it to the streets, the question is, what is it that we are taking? Whatever it is that is your voice, if it's the voice of peace, the voice of justice, compassion. If you are a teacher, a doctor, a janitor, whatever your voice is in the world, you are carried by love. So prayer to action is the 4th and 5th principle. Love in action, 4th and 5th principle. God is where I stand and where I am and where I move and where I have my being. 4th and 5th principle. This is where the rubber meets the road. This is where we take all of our spiritual practice, our belief, and we put it into the world. So this is no small topic, right? This is no, it's no small thing for us to make that move, because it's safe for us to sit in contemplation and affirm the oneness of our being. It is safe for us to sit and say God is the one power and the presence of the universe, and God is good, and therefore I am good, and I have that spark of the divine, and through my thoughts I create my reality, and I may sit in prayer, commune with the divine. All of that is very safe. But when we get to that 5th step, that 5th principle, it is not enough to know truth. I would say that even more correctly spoken, it's not that it's not enough, but if we are in that knowing, we will be compelled to take it to action. We will be compelled to live that truth, because we certainly can't keep that kind of truth to ourselves, can we? And so it's not about then proselytizing and convincing other people to believe as we do. And so that's a mistake that has been made throughout human history in many different regards. But to actually live and be the presence of that which we believe, of that which we know, to allow love to carry us in and through our own unique experience of animation, if you will. So we just stop right there. We don't even know what that looks like, do we? We just sit in that place of movement, of shift, from knowing to being. The first sight. We don't exactly know what's going to happen. And so in Unity, we talk a lot about law of attraction. So we vision something, and then we attract that into our lives and into our experiences. But first sight would have us be really careful about that process. Because we often make the mistake of, well, I want that job, I want that car, I want that relationship, I want that house. And we sort of corrupt the process by actually limiting ourselves in that. Because we're going by really copying what's in the world, as opposed to being that divine original in the world. So what we might say instead is, I want a job where I can use this gift, where I can feel myself expressing as the divine. I want a home where my family feels safe and comfortable and cozy, where we can eat together, play together. I want a car that I can use to get me to that job, or to that place of service, or to that relationship where I am living, breathing God as me. And so when we open that first sight to possibility, we open ourselves to full potential. And we don't necessarily attach to the outcome. Because in that process of unfolding, we open to greater possibility, and we will stumble upon things which we could not previously imagine. And so I'm going to give you an example that's happening right now in the news. If you're anybody watching the Olympics, the Winter Olympics, okay, how about the Korean women's hockey team? Okay, they combined North and South Korea, and it was one Korean team. So the women played yesterday, and they lost to the Swiss team, 8-0. But I have to say, there was not a loser in that game. There was not a loser. And if you listen to the sportscasters and the newscasters and the media, everyone is saying, well, we don't know what will come of this. We don't know. The team came together. Korea marched in unity at the opening ceremonies, and this team competed together. And so they're in an environment that by nature is competitive, right? You go there not only to do your best, but then to do better than everybody else. Right? This is where world records are broken. So the environment itself is ripe with competition. And this team came together. These two countries came together. And the question is, well, what next? What's going to happen after this? And nobody knows. That is the example of what happens internally when we take a step towards first sight. Nobody knows what's going to happen. But there has been a vision of peace, of unity, of love, of right living, of right action. And we don't know where it's going to take us. But we know we must move in this direction. And so that is like a perfect example, perfect nugget of what happens to each of us internally. When we are in that question of who am I to be in the world? How am I to live? What is my right action to take? Is to know that you might not know exactly what's going to happen after that. And that's okay. Because if we are moving in a way that we are allowing love to carry us, we are living our divine potential. We are living the path, the spiritual path, the journey, whatever words we want to attach to it, because we can't really exactly explain what it is. That is the direction in which we must go. So the Hebrew scriptures, Genesis 1, the creation story, gives us a pattern for creativity, for creating life, for it is the creative process. So day 3 is this movement. Anybody know it? Okay. Does somebody know? Let the seas gather in one place and let the dry land appear. Let the seas, the waters of our thought, of our potential, of all that is God and divine mind, gather into one place. That is the prayer action. That is the fourth principle. And let the dry land appear. So it comes from within that potential. That is the fifth principle, prayer to action. And so since we are interspiritual, you know, we'll move from the Old Testament, where then we can go on to find stories of Moses and the Pharaoh of Egypt and that relationship, addressing the trade for love of power to the power of love. We can move forward into the Christian scriptures and find Jesus in the Roman Empire, and we can find that movement of shifting from love of power to power of love. And then I want to read a little bit from Andrew Harvey, who's a great mystic, in his book, Essential Mystics, because he beautifully brings this inner spiritual aspect to it. The Christian revelation at its richest, contains and reflects the Kogi and Hopi knowledge of the interconnection of all life, the Taoist sense of organic balance and the mysterious conjunction of opposites, the Hindu awareness of the grandeur of the soul, the Buddhist devotion to compassion and clear ethical living, the Jewish awe at the unutterable holiness of God and the sacredness of ordinary life, the Greek adoration of divine beauty, and the Islamic passion for God as the beloved. For me, training in Hindu, Buddhist, and Sufi paths helped me to see just how profound the Christian mystics are and how much a seeker on any path has to learn from them. And that is so important to bring that in, because all of the paths are dealing with the aesthetic of beauty, with the experience of love, with the grandeur of life, of God. So if we are all seeking, as humanity, a path of unfolding, a way of being in the world, it is about that shift from 1, 2, 3, and 4 to the fifth principle, that unfolding. Now, how do I appear? How do I make my grand entrance into the world as someone who understands and knows and or is open to a deeper awareness and understanding of the divine? And it's not a linear move. It is cyclical. It is smashed kind of all up on top of each other. So we don't first sit, one power, one presence in the universe. Ah, yes, and that presence is in me and all my thoughts. You know, we don't sit in that linear move and go through it 1, 2, 3, but because we operate in linear time, it's helpful. It's helpful to have a framework. But then we have to step out of that and to know that it's happening all at the same time. And so it's not that once we come to a place of action that we've got 1 through 4. I don't have to worry about that anymore. I graduated. We're 6. I'm ready. You know, it's not how it happens. It's a moving back, because as soon as we move into action and we bump up against someone else's idea of the way things should be, I guarantee we're going to need to return to that first principle. God is. Therefore, I am, and I am good as God is, and so is she. Right? Okay. And so we work with these concepts, we work with these ideas to help carry us through that action and that movement. So it's not a matter of graduating through the principles. It's a matter of practicing them and knowing that it's a movement that might feel like it's coming back and forth, but it's really just moving together. So I'm going to invite those who were in the class to stand, because I want us to step into a knowing. Yes. That among this community, these people and a few others who couldn't be here today, have stepped into a greater commitment to that movement of prayer to action. They've opened themselves up to bring that into their consciousness more deeply, and that impacts everyone in this community. So I want us to affirm together that which we are taking to the streets is the power of love. And now I'd like everyone to rise. And so we're going to just take a moment, take a time to really feel that power of love. Somebody, I think it was you, Kathy, talked about feeling the strength in numbers. We can get overwhelmed by yet another mass shooting, yet another war, yet another experience of police brutality, or all of these painful things. We look into the eyes of starving children. It's easy to get sort of overwhelmed by what's happening in the world, but we must remind ourselves of all the good and of all of those who are committed to being that action of taking the power of love to the streets, of taking spiritual practice, of taking the activity of God, of being that presence in the world. So I want each of us to connect in that way. And so if for you that's a hug, or for you it's a handshake, or a gentle knowing, I would like for us to pass the peace to one another and speak the affirmation one to another. You are the power of love. You are the power of love. So let's have a time. Mm-hmm.